we are here to talk about Selu Oasis Systems. Selu is a new technology that is going to help bring water and energy affordably to the world and enable the communities that have struggled with food insecurity for so many years, if not centuries, to be able to actually grow their own food, feed their villages. It's such an exciting project. And with us today is Jake Hammock, the CEO and founder. Jake is a futurist, a creator and inventor. He's a technologist and an environmental pioneer. And I'm proud to call Jake a friend and so happy that he's here to share with us today. Jake truly envisions a world where water and energy are no longer scarce. And now he's going to tell us how we're going to get there. Jake, welcome. And thank you so much for being here.
Absolutely a pleasure. Thank you so much for having me, Lauren.
So tell us, what is Selu Oasis and what are the problems you're actually solving?
Yeah, would love to. Selu Oasis is a solution that will enable communities to truly be self-sustainable. And so we're starting to solve our problems with creating a climate control environment for agricultural indoor facilities so that we can solve some of the greatest problems of food security in our future. So that's what we've done and what we're doing now.
So it means until now, for instance, what do they call it? A hothouse?
Greenhouse.
Greenhouse, a hothouse. That the levels of temperature are just not dependable. Is that it? And that you can't actually sustain a consistent temperature?
Yeah, generally speaking, that's what greenhouses, vertical farms, even cannabis growers, hydroponics, aeroponics, they generally struggle within how to climate control their environment. So there's several devices out there aimed at just doing that, and they all consume energy to do it. So dehumidifiers, swamp coolers, CO2 injectors, HVAC units, these devices all, think about them all fighting each other, simply trying to climate control an environment to regulate your temperature and humidity to really create the perfect atmosphere to grow crops and to grow food. Where we come in at is to say, well, we don't need any of these devices anymore. Why don't we have one universal solution to reduce your energy costs substantially while regulating your environment to really and more affordably grow more crops for the world?
So is this a device that, what, you attach it to the greenhouse or you attach it to another building? Is that how it works?
Yeah, the product itself, our solution is a hardware technology that attaches right next to a greenhouse. And we use a combustible fuel line system, which could be to a degree any combustible fuel, so natural gas or hydrogen or methane or propane. And we use that gas in a way to convert energy from it. And that energy then allows us to provide air cooling, humidity control regulation. We reclaim the water from the atmosphere, high humidity in greenhouses, right? If you walk in a greenhouse, you're immediately confronted with high humidity. Generally not great for plants.
Not good for my hair either.
Right? Yeah. So we want to stay away from that. And really what we've done, we want to deliver water in these utilities where they're needed most, right into the soil, right into the environment. So that when you walk into a greenhouse, it's not this, you know, frizz hair environment everywhere and humidity that's corrupting these plants and these seeds. It's more now of calibrated, regulated, and we can increase economic value for our customers in our market.
And you can also, I'm understanding from what I was reading, that you can deploy these units literally to the villages themselves or to the local areas. So the food growth is now local to the population that needs it instead of having to ship food across continents. Is that right?
Absolutely right. That's our core mission and vision within Selu, is to create sustainable communities. And so the Oasis product line is our first initiative to do just that, so that we can produce food closer to consumers. We don't rely now within having access to expensive utility grids or centralized utility grids or water main lines, etc. So long as we have a heat fuel source coupled with our system, we can deploy this technology within remote villages, within areas of the world that were deemed barren and desolate, so that we can now produce more crops. And by virtue of this, with our technology in the world, we can replenish the earth simultaneously by providing more water back into the atmosphere.
I love that. And you know, the research that I was doing for this, you know, it's crazy how much I can learn. I'm so happy to know I can still learn stuff. But I was reading, well, because talking to you is always a lesson, but I was reading that Bill Gates is not only one of the wealthiest men in the world, but he actually is the largest owner of farmland in the United States. And I thought, wow, he probably owns some of the property that you would like to be interacting with. So if you were going to sit down with Bill Gates and have a conversation, how would that go?
I would love to have a conversation with Bill, and I would love to create a model so that we can prove that there is a better way of our future for the world, with an enhancing food security and creating not just sustainable communities, but sustainable communities that have a continuous and reliable access to the utilities and precious resources of life they need. And what I mean by that is we can certainly model this in the US. We have the infrastructure to do this. We have the technology to do that. We have the partnerships to do this, to create an on-demand climate controlling environment to just solve one of our many problems of Earth, and food security is where we're starting at within Selu. But I would love to model this with Bill in such a way, how can we scale this into developing areas of the world where it's needed most? So the US can be truly a beacon once again to the world that we are not only innovative, but we are going to partner with that of the globe to show we can produce food closer to consumers. And really, by doing that, how can we replenish the earth continuously, not just by water back into the atmosphere, but also with economic gain and prosperity to the consumers of this food. So it's more so than just maintaining these systems or distribution, et cetera, and all the fruitful commerce lines. It's more of really taking care of the planet that we're gifted to be on. And I would love to model this with Bill one day.
Who is Selu?
So Selu is the Cherokee, Native American Cherokee, goddess of the corn and first woman of the earth. And we embodied her vision, her spirit, into the name of our venture so that we can become caretakers of the earth. And she is a very interesting story. I can tell more in detail that she sacrificed her own life so that the earth can be replenished with food and corn and provide not just the precious nutrients of life, but that spirit of moving forward with everything that we are and we can do into being in this beautiful world.
Oh my gosh,
I love that.
So I have a quick question, Jake. Yeah. Who is your target customer? Like, if we wanted to like implement this, or if we wanted to support you on these goals, which we do, who are the people who are going to be able to implement what you have to offer?
Yeah, so our target customer are agribusinesses or ag-enabled businesses. And what I mean by that is, you know, greenhouses that are an entity that are selling crops or produce to include growing livestock feed to supply our meat and cattle industries. Mm-hmm. But this also includes vertical farms. When I say agribusinesses, it's a very large category, right? Anyone that would grow food in a greenhouse and create commerce from that, we can offset their utility expenses substantially and then allow them to have more economic prosperity, produce more crops for their intended customers in our market, which we're all consumers of food. So I'm talking to myself in a way. And I would love to have food grown locally. I would love to have it grown more economically at an advantage so that it's it can replicate. And we can empower these businesses to also scale, meaning that there's a lot of upfront capital to start a greenhouse. You know, when you think of starting maybe a 20,000 or 30,000 square foot greenhouse, generally the first question that comes into mind is how much are my utility expenses? How much are my lights and irrigation pumps and HVAC for fans to heat and cool the place? And so where we come in at is saying, well, now you can start this at a much reduced rate, at a much lower cost, so that we can produce more food and crops for the world.
Wow, that's really amazing.
So Jake, if our viewers, as I hope they will, and I know they will, want to know more, want to follow, even want to join along with you on your mission, how can they do that?
They can visit us on our website at Selu, S-E-L-U dot earth.
Love that website.
That's amazing. That's my favorite one I've heard in a long time.
we discovered that we could have a .earth domain, and we realized, well, we're solving, you know, some of the greatest problems on Earth. Why not have a .earth domain? And it just made perfect sense for us. They can check out our website there, or they can send us a note at contact@selu.earth, or follow us on our various social media sites, LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter.
Perfect. Thank you so much for coming to share with us today. It's such exciting stuff that's coming up for you. So good luck with everything. And it's going to be a great new year.
Really do appreciate it. Thank you so much, Lauren and Amy, for having me on the show today.
Our pleasure. And we'll be right back. We'll